सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहे तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहे। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमाधाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ ईशावास्यमिदं सर्वम् ॐ ईशावास्यमिदं सर्वम् यत्किञ्च जगत्यां जगत् यत्किञ्च जगत्यां जगत् तेन त्यक्तेन भुञ्जीथाः तेन त्यक्तेन भुञ्जीथाः मा गृधः कस्य स्विद्धनम् कस्य सिद्धनम्। ॐ ईशावास्यमिदं सर्वं यत्किञ्च जगत्यां जगत् ॐ ईशावास्यमिदं सर्वं यत्किञ्च जगत्यां जगत् तेन त्यक्तेन भुञ्जीथाः मा गृधः कस्य स्विद्धनम् तेन त्यक्तेन भुञ्जीथाः मा गृधः कस्य स्विद्धनम्। कुर्वन्नेवेह कर्माणि कुर्वन्नेवेह कर्माणि जिजिविषेत् शतगुं समाः नेवेह कर्माणि जिजिविषेत् एवथैव कुर्वन्तु नाकु न बोलो। एवं त्वयि नान्यथेतोऽस्ति एवं त्वयि नान्यथेतोऽस्ति न कर्म लिप्यते नरे न कर्म लिप्यते नरे। कुर्वन्नेवेह कर्माणि जिजिविषेत् शतगुं समाः कुर्वन्नेवेह कर्माणि जिजिविषेत् शतगुं समाः। एवं त्वयि नान्यथेतोऽस्ति न कर्म लिप्यते नरे एवं त्वयि नान्यथेतोऽस्ति न कर्म लिप्यते नरे। लास्ट टाइम वी सॉ इह मीन्स मनुष्य जन्मनि मनुष्य लोके इन द ह्यूमन बर्थ विच इज ब्लेस्ड इन अ सेंस वी हैव सेंस ऑफ डूअरशिप सेल्फ अवेयरनेस इज सो मच दैट देयर इज अ डूअरशिप एंड एंजॉयरशिप देयरफॉर एन एनिमल्स और एनी अदर स्पीशीज योनि अदर देन ह्यूमन बीइंग डजंट हैव दिस। So their all karmas are only shariryatrarth for the survival. And survival involves arthakama, security and pleasure, that being a basic need. They live only for that. Whereas, see, we enjoy buddhi and lot of freedom over our jnana shakti, ichha shakti, kriya shakti. And therefore, we have another purusharta called dharma and moksha. Two more purusharthas are there. And therefore, iha manushya loke. First thing is, karma, I told in the conclusion, means kartavya karma. That we will see a little later. But one must act. One must keep oneself busy. Not just doing nothing. But then, the body is given with a purpose. Human birth is with a special purpose of dharma and moksha. You cannot lead a purposeless life. Not only you should act, but you may say, I may not have ambition to achieve something, to have a big goal. That's fine. But then at least learn, keep learning, keep growing. You have to be a bubbly and enthusiastic person in the life. You cannot just live a life of vegetativeness. One should never. You just don't let yourself loose. Otherwise, watching the TV all the time, and that, what is that sofa? In US it is called. Which couch? The potato couch, potato or something they say. There is one sofa, you know. That's a name. I forgot it. What they call it? And then you end up becoming L and XL and double XL and 3XL. That's not the human life. Even hippopotamus is triple XL. You don't need to be born as a human being. At least develop your skill. Something you have to do. Now coming to this karma. I had left it why, and why should we be doing obligatory duty, obligatory actions or duty-based karma? And what do we mean by that karma? First of all, let us understand the answer to why. Every living being, living creature, he survives only because it receives so many things from the world outside. Whether it is a human baby or baby of animal, like elephant or lion or tiger or a cat or birds, siblings, whatever. You receive first of all from parents, then you receive from the nature. All natural forces are contributing for your survival, for your growth, and to some extent for your happiness also. That means you are a receiver. And among all species, human child is, or a human baby is, a receiver for the longest period of time. You see, this baby born to even giraffe or a deer or a cow or an elephant, they just start walking within 1 or 2 hours. They walk. And within 2-3 months, they start finding their own food. They are independent of mom. There may be some bond, instinctual, the awareness that she is mother for security. But they are independent. Within maximum 6 months to 1 year, they are out independently surviving. Maybe calf or a puppy or a cub or whatever it is. They are on their own. But human child, to be on their own, takes minimum 20 to 25 years. Even to stand on its two legs, it takes minimum 1 year. And that too uncertain. Plus, minus, and up to from 1 to 3 years, falls and runs and doesn't have balance and things like that. All kinds of problems. Then in Gujarati, again, potana pag upar ubha rahva mate. It takes 20, 25 years. Modern children may take more. Well, they want to go to university and then do post-graduation, and especially even in America, that is okay, they are on their own once they go, father supports, parent supports, but they take loans. But in America, Indian parents will pay for all the education fees and get them married, give them samskara. So we are a receiver for a long, long time. And you receive from entire creation. You know, just think of this, one cup of tea you have. Now, how many people or how many, let's say people or institutions have contributed to get you a cup of tea? Think of this. First of all, you need fire. That means you need gas. Nowadays we have gas pipeline. You start from the time when somebody discovered gas underneath the earth. And then onward, those companies and the research scientists and the workers and the plants, they develop the methodology whereby they can transport that gas from the source to your home. In between, there may be so many stations. They may be pushing it through pressure. And makes there again to develop this technology of the pipes, which doesn't get affected by the gas. And then stove and the burner and the cooking range and whole blessed thing. That is going on since so many years. Maybe a couple of centuries, at least in India, I know. In the 18th century, there is a company called Oil India, British company. A Britisher went to Assam, Dibrugarh site, to look for some metal underneath. And they dug it. And he found the gas. And they didn't know what to do. By the time Europe had discovered this, 1820 or 1860 something, I'll find out the date and let you know next class. The name also, because ONGC chief had, regional chief was one of those days my student, and he had told me that our Oil India was the first company in India to produce oil and petrol and gas. And then he had told me this story. In the beginning, they had cylinders. They developed the pressure pumps to fill in the cylinder with pressure. They must be transporting a gas with pressure, and to develop a pressure, we have a pressure pumps. So we are in, those people who develop the pumps, pressure pumps, we are indebted to them. And all this is possible because of the electricity, pressure pumps. So one who discovered the electricity and where from that electricity comes, which hydroelectricity or atomic electricity or coal, whatever, you don't know. And then for hydro also, who built the dams and all those laborers and workers and technology and onwards, and those get turbines to produce electricity and cable, and all those laborers who laid the cable and laid those huge, very tall pillars, and they must have crossed mountains, and they might have used helicopters or helicopter technology. This is only for gas I'm talking, okay? I have not come to tea so far. And tea gardens, and somebody discovering that these leaves you can drink and it gives you some intoxication. In the gardens, and then those tea gardens, the women plucking the tree, at least in India I know, they pluck the leaves, and I have seen the processing plant. Then they have to dry it and then do some process, and then they produce tea, and that produced tea is certainly may not be manufactured in America or coming from some other continent. And those continent, when it is coming, then all the ships is involved, and ship technology and gas, and then they use those engines, and then and so many things. including the trucks and the Walmart fellows and all the staffs and everything. Then comes sugar, then comes milk, and then comes water. All that can be disrupted. You know, these are minimum five ingredients I'm talking. Look at the interconnectivity of the universe. When certain events like this happen, my mind thinks sometimes very different tangent, you know. So this is how I thought. One policeman killing one black person. America people know this. And that triggered riots in all over America. And in many areas, many, at least half a dozen of our Indian origin Americans told me on phone, hey, Swamiji, we are short of some ration because the shop which we were buying, they have broken. So we are thankful to all those black people that they didn't break so that we could buy the tea, we could buy the milk, we could buy, get the water. So many things. I can go on and on for whole night just for your one cup of tea till you ask for two cups of tea. Now let's have tea, Swamiji. I have enough headache. You talk so much about it. The life is so dependent on your survival. And the people who contributed or contributing goes back to a couple of centuries minimum. All the natural forces, which cow's milk you are drinking or taking in a cup of tea, you don't know. You know, and that too the cow can give only when she has delivered a baby, and the delivered because she conceived, and how she conceived you don't know. Whole ancestors of that bull and those cow have contributed for you for this cup of tea. Because if the cow's mother was not there, you don't have a cow. If the calf was not there, you don't have a milk. And cow's mother's mother should be there so that her daughter's daughter is born. It goes on. Endless. Similarly, which plant emits oxygen that we are inhaling? And which plant is inhaling our carbon dioxide which exhales? You don't know. Where from your vegetable comes? You just have it in a plate and you eat it, even if you eat cucumbers. Transport industry is involved and refrigeration industry is involved. Cold storages are involved and handling people are involved. Shipping, road, everything. And that human child takes for 20 to 25 years. This I am talking of only food. Think of the body of knowledge. Think of the body of knowledge in the field of medicine. We just take a tablet, something happened and you take it. But then how it was discovered, you don't know. Even this computer, you just take it for granted. Those days, I remember there were valves, radios, you know, 12-band radio, such a big radio, and in the home they used to put it in showcase and all. From the valve then came a transistor technology, and from transistor technology came chip tech. And again miniature and all that. I remember 2 GB was a big storage place once upon a time. And now, 256 GB and 128 GB is common. You know, it's so common. Even phone, so many things. I was told, since I have diabetes and I am having for the last 17, 18 years, one of the doctors told me, there were 2 brothers who discovered the insulin of diabetes. They first of all identified this diabetes, they came to know, those scientists. And they wanted to try the insulin on that. So they tried on the dogs. And literally, they injected diabetes to the dogs, and those scientists literally ran after those dogs to collect their urine to test that it is still sugar or not. On their clothes, collected. And one of them finally tried on himself. The modern protocol of discovery was not so vivid in those days. So many scientists, they have contributed. The culture, the values, you got it, they have contributed. So you are born indebted and you grow indebted. And even when you become independent, start earning, you still continue to be indebted because you need a cup of tea next day also. Only thing is you started earning some money. So, as a token of our gratitude to the entire universe, appreciation of our indebtedness, an expression of our gratitude, three types of karmas are to be done. They are called runam in Sanskrit, indebtedness. We are runam. One is Devaruna, second is Pitruruna, and third is Rishiruna. Pitruruna means whole humanity, all ancestors whose genes I have inherited, and they all contributed to my growth. My father helped me directly, but his father helped him, therefore he is here. He gave him samskara, and then his father was given samskara by his father's father. All that. And whole humanity, culture, etc., values. So, this is called Pitrurunam, indebtedness towards our ancestors and our fellow human beings. Devarunam, all natural forces. Surya Devata, Chandra Devata, Vanaspati Devata, Parvat Devata, Indra Devata, all Devatas. And Rishiranam, the body of knowledge that I've inherited. And not only knowledge and inherit, but knowledge and technology also. You know, in those days I have still seen those cookers before the pressure cooker came. I have seen those. Even the blenders, you have just put it ready, then it has to be done physically. All technologies and sciences, what is available is that the recent or the latest technology is a put one step ahead of the last latest. The last latest is one step ahead of the one. How many persons had contributed in terms of science, in terms of dharma, in terms of any other discipline of knowledge. So symbolically, Rishi Ranam. So Shastra gives certain karmas whereby you, as a gesture of gratitude, you perform certain karmas addressing to Pitrus, addressing to Devatas, addressing to Rishis. One. Secondly, they also take some other karma. Your survival involves some kind of himsa. Some kind of killing, knowingly or unknowingly. Like a medicine that you take, I am told, this medicine are first of all tried on the mice and the cats and chimpanzees and finally men. What works for chimpanzee, it works for men, they hope so. And then they do clinical trials. So many things kill. Even when you travel in the evening in monsoon or summer at night and you switch on your headlights of the car, all those insects get killed. They just come and they get killed because of your velocity, because of accident with your dashboard. Like that, we end up doing lots of hinsa. So there are five yagnas that are taught daily. Brahma yagna, Nru yagna, Deva yagna, ityadi yagnas are there. All these descriptions is there in the third chapter. Bhagavad Gita. Some of you are attending Gujarati classes of Mataji. She must have taught you just 6 months ago. She started recently the fourth chapter, and I think during March, April only she was teaching that. Other than that, these are the karmas. When kurvanneveha karmani means runa apakarana arthe, expressing our gratitude, some karmas, as a prayaschitta, antidote for some himsa, that minimum you end up doing one way or the other. And thirdly, as I said, we are interconnected human being. The whole society, whole universe functions in an order. There is an order. For particles and atoms, there is a physics, order of physics. There is an order, a law of chemistry, for chemicals. There is an order of biology, law of biology. Therefore, plant kingdom. There is an order of zoology, for animal kingdom. Various orders are there. What is the law for human society? That is called law of dharma, law of karma. And what is that law? What is the kartavya karma? What is it that I am obliged to do? That is what that is called dharma. What is I am it's obligatory on my part is called dharma. Okay, what is dharma? There are two dharmas, samanya dharma and vishesha dharma. Samanya means universal. These are the things to be done by all. All includes male, female, any sex. All includes any nationality. All includes any religion. All includes any place, everything. Samanya dharmas. Like, these dharmas are based on mutual behavioral expectation. And fortunately, these expectations are universal. Therefore, these dharmas are universal. Universally, we expect the same behavior from others. And that person also expects the same. Like, for example, speaking truth. Each one of us wants the other person should speak truth. My partner or my colleague should be honest to me. That is what they also expect. They may not steal my things. They may not lie to me. That is expectation. It has nothing to do with education. Just imagine a situation of Stone Age men. There was one head, village head, Mukhi, we call it, who would give justice. And those days, what kind of suits were fine? The suits were only this much. I killed, my arrow killed this cat. This fellow, no, but first my arrow had hit it. That's all they would fight. In those days, you know, this is my prey and that is my prey. And the judge is there, that head, village head is sitting to give a judgment, to make to give the right person, the right person his dues. And when these two guys argue, one will invariably say, don't tell lie. Even before you came, my arrow had hit it. And you had told me like this, etc. Even those days, they don't want others to lie. Without education. And a Nobel laureate also wants the same thing. No one wants to be hurt. I don't want you to hurt me, either by your deeds or words or even by thoughts. No one likes if someone tells you that another guy was telling ill about you. This fellow gets hurt. Dislike you, have these things for me, get hurt. So what we call in a common jargon values, that is called samanya dharma, ethical values. Vishesha dharma depends on person to person, time to time, place to place, nation to nation, and sometimes from religion to religion. If you have a car to drive on your left is India's Vishesha Dharma. And in the same car you go to US, you have to drive on the right, that's a Vishesha Dharma. From country to country. Certain etiquettes, cultural etiquettes are there. What is the etiquette? I have to learn, and I keep learning. Every time I come there, I remind that you have to say thank you to everybody. You have to say sorry to everybody. They say thank you to their spouse also. Oh, thank you, honey. And then you have to request them. Will you please bring that salt from the kitchen? And she brings it, will you please bring? He is on the dining table. And then she brings, and he will say, thank you, honey. If it is Indian husband, typical. Chakma mithu nahi kyu banaye? There is less salt in the vegetable. What kind of vegetable you cook? He will shout like this. Even the child will shout like this. Mom, what is this? And then she understands, that means I have to give him salt. And he did not say thank you. You are used to almost in a commanding jargon, certainly not polite. And you just bring the salt. You know, you just say that in culture. But they get hurt. So it's a cultural vishesha dharma. And if you don't say thank you, again they get hurt. They say, this fellow is mannerless. I remember 15, 17 years ago, one of my students from Baroda, old student, they were attending classes in 84, 85. His daughter, soon after schooling, had moved to US, and a teenager, and she had some uncle and family, so she said, I want to study there, and they moved her, and she was born there, citizen. So by the time she grew up, and then fortunately this parent said, we will look for a match for you, some of our Indian caste, and they were Patels, and there are many Patels available in USA, you know. So fortunately she said, okay. Of course 15 years ago, so it was not, it's okay, that's good. Right? Today, if our daughter agrees, it is extra fortunate that she gives you a chance to look for us. Anyway, so they suggested a couple of boys, and then he came, and then we'll go out and sort of just talk and in a restaurant. And he came to pick her up. So I happened to go same day. They'd got out on Sunday morning, and I was having lunch, and then the discussion came, how is the boy? What's your take on it? She had few points of non-acceptance. But what shocked me was this one point, you know. And what did she say? Swamiji, he is mannerless. When I came, he didn't open the door and meet me sit. And when we reached the restaurant, he should have opened my door first. I had to open myself, mannerless. Beja Jalmani. The cultural values, you know. This is Vishesha Dharma. Her parents couldn't understand what's a big deal about it. He didn't open, nobody opens here in India. You have to open yourself and get seated and full stop and close by yourself. But that's how it is. So culturally, nationally, and as I said, some dharmas because of relation, certain karmas. If you are married and as a husband or a wife, there are certain obligatory actions of husband, of wife, of mother, of father, of son, of daughter, of brother, of sister, of cousin, etc., etc. They are called vishesha dharma. That karma is to be performed only to this person. Because you are husband or wife to only to one person. To son, father's dharma is only to one son or to whatever you have. You are not father to whole universe except Lord Shankara and Parvati. Jagatapitaru vande. Parvati Parameshwaru. Shiva and Parvati are universal parents. But they have their universal dharma. But you have to speak truth universe. Not only to your two sons and two daughters or whatever children, but to the whole universe. That's a samanya dharma. And this is vishesha. Thus, those karmas to be performed as an expression or repayment of my runam, those prayaschitta karmas, some himsa I do those, some contributory karmas, contributing to nature, certain yajnas, certain rituals, all those karmas, they are universal. Every human being should do that. And fourth is vishesh karmas, specific karmas to the specific relationship. I have a relation being a citizen of this country or whatever, you have to do that. So karma means this, kurvan neve karma. Keep performing these that you have. Minimum. And then, as I say, should you have time, develop your skills. Develop your wisdom. Do something more to help yourself to grow. This first step, kurvan neveha karmani jijivishet satam sama. May you have desire for long life, it's natural. But then, while fulfilling the desire for survival, you keep performing these all four types of karmas. Okay. Now the second line. एवं त्वयि नान्यथेतोस्ति न कर्म लिप्यते नरे एवं त्वयि फॉर सच पर्सन फॉर यू सच यू हू वांट्स टू लिव 100 इयर्स फॉर देयर इज नो वे अदर देन दिस न अन्यथा इतः अस्ति देयर इज नो वे अदर देन This nanya theto asti, there is a sandhi. Na anyatha itaha asti. No other way other than this. Whereby na lipyate, na karma lipyate nare. Whereby you don't get bound, you don't get afflicted and inflicted both. By karmas, this is the only way. What does it mean? Please understand. While performing duty, all four karmas, our shastra gives certain attitude. Karma per se binds the person. Because karma gives rise to karma phalam. And as a human being, I have a sense of doership. So means I am doing karma, and therefore the result also will come to me. So every karma will produce new results, and these results are infinite and varied. That means I'll continue to be in samsara. And here the shastra says, there is no way other than this whereby you are not afflicted. I mean, this is the only way whereby you are not afflicted by karma. Now I am telling you, okay, you will be afflicted. What is it? Why do I say that? Why Shastra says so? The answer is, whenever we perform a duty, whenever we perform any obligatory action, may it be this runa purti, may it be some prayaschitta, daily prayaschitta, maybe naimittika karma, sometime you do, maybe samanya dharma, maybe vishesha. They give only one attitude. Technically speaking, nitya karma is sandhya vandanam, Gayatri, that one has to do daily. Then when you do Gayatri, you know, that is to be done daily. Agnihotra is to be done daily. And then, all this if you do daily, then that Shastra has one attitude. What is the attitude? Ishvara prityarthe idam aham karomi. As an offering to Ishvara. So, all obligatory duties are performed in the awareness of Ishvara. Which Ishvara? Not Satyam Jnanam Anantam. If that is there, then there is no karma. Shastra said in the earlier mantra, Isha Vasya Vidam Sarva. May you appreciate, may you see, this is the fact. But until I see, I have a bhava. As Pujya Swami Dayanand used to say, fake it and make it. Keep doing it, then you will develop. These are the things to be done with appreciation. But if not, keep doing it with attitude. Someday, you can convert the attitude into your appreciation, in your knowledge. It can be converted into cognition. So, keep doing whatever it is Ishvara. Whatever obligatory duty I am doing it, see, this is why people don't want to follow dharma. Any dharma, dharma means any kartavya karma, any duty. My duty is a right or benefit of someone else. My duty is some benefit to someone, other one is a beneficiary. Whatever may be my duty, like husband's duty, that the beneficiary is wife. Wife's duty, beneficiary is husband. Father's duty, beneficiary is children. Children's duty, beneficiary is father. Someone else is always benefited. Something, somebody in the creation. Now, everything is Ishvara ultimately. Isha Vasyam Idam Sarvam. When you see some individual as a beneficiary, there will be tendency to expect the return. I did so much, that person should do so much. There will be pain. I did so much, but they didn't do it, or they are not doing it. There will be hurt. Dharma, like a typical Indian scenario, you know, there are elder brother takes care of another two younger and all that. They are always grumbling. We did so much for them, but they don't value us. Sometimes people in the family also feel, you don't value me. You have no respect for me. I'm doing so much for you. I've done so much for your family. You don't have respect. See it as an offering to Ishvara. He has placed me in this situation. He's a karma adhyaksha, karma phala data. He has put me in this situation. And that means he wants me to do this, full stop. Every situation dictates a response from you, if you are sensible. People are not sensible enough, or people are lost in some other pleasures or something. Then they don't see that what is expected of them in that situation. But if you are sensitive, if you have a little leisure, you can make out in this situation, what should I be doing? And fact that Ishvara doesn't give mandate every time. Fact that he has placed me in this situation, that means he wants me to do this, full stop. What is expected out of me in a given situation? What is it that I am supposed to do in a given situation? Is nothing but wish of the Ishvara. They say, thy wish will be fulfilled. Thy wish will be fulfilled means only this. Be a person who is committed to duty. Be a person who is committed to all obligatory actions. Whatever it is I have to do, full stop. And I shall do it. Who has put me? Ishvara. So to do the things as an offering to Ishvara, that attitude releases one from the bondage of karma. That attitude makes one free relatively from the afflictions of karma and karma phala. This is a karma yoga. We have to talk yoga separately, this attitude in modern times. But Veda, if you see sankalpa, any sankalpa, beginning from Rajasu Yajna onwards, daily Gayatri. What sankalpa means? Declaration of intent. What for I am doing? The first sentence is Mamopata Samasta Duritakshay Dvara Shri Ishvara Prityarthe. This I am doing as an offering to Ishvara. Then they add everything. Dharmartha Kama Praptyarthe Ayurvayaroga Sarayaga Praptyarthe. This is a long list. Then it changes depending upon the purpose for which you are doing. You may do it for suswastha, for good health only. You may do it with some money, that's okay. But then first is Ishvara. So, performing karma is an offering to Ishvara. This attitude, other than this attitude, there is no other way whereby you may not get afflicted by karma and karma phala. That means only if you act with this attitude, you are not afflicted. There is no other way, there is nothing other than this. Look at this. The situation that I am in is given by God. Number one. to comprehend the situation and understand what I am to supposed to do, that comprehensive capacity is also given by Bhagavan. And the resources to do, the shakti to do what I am expected to do, is also given by Bhagavan. It's a gift of Ishvara. So, karmaphal data Ishvara. So, while perform karma in the awareness of Ishvara. And which Ishvara? The one who is karmaphala data, the one who is karma dakshaha. That attitude is the only way not to get bound, not to get afflicted, not to get attached by karma and karmaphala. Evam tvai nanyathetosti na karma lipyate nare. In human being, this cannot connect. There is a third mantra, there is a shift in it. We will see that mantra next week. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Guru Namah Hari Om.